Age six, Urmila began work as a maid for a banker in Nepal's capital, Kathmandu, hundreds of kilometres from her family.
I worked non-stop from 6 in the morning until I went to bed at 10 o'clock. I did all the household chores, cooking, cleaning and looking after the children. At age six, I looked after the master's five-year-old daughter.
Urmila's family belonged to the Tharu people in southern Nepal. Traditionally landless, the Tharu have few options of earning a living, and many end up embracing a kamalari contract. A bonded labour system, kamalari sees girls as young as six working as maids in wealthy homes. Often far from home, the girls are isolated and vulnerable to physical violence and sexual abuse. In 2005, Plan began working with local NGO Swan. Since then, Plan has rescued and supported nearly 2,000 girls in one district alone. The younger girls are helped back to school or given support with their education. But for those too old to go back to school, Plan provides vocational training and business startup support. Several have set up tea shops or cafes, others have opened shops or sell handicraft. Plan also supports parents with livelihood schemes so they don't have to send their daughters out to work. But the Kamalari project is also out to change hearts and minds. Dramas, rallies and family visits seek to change local attitudes to girls. The girls themselves have set up a campaign group made up of more than 2,000 freed Kamalari. They have lobbied and advocated both locally and nationally to try and abolish the Kamalari practice. Now there are four communities completely free of this practice, and Plan has expanded the project to two more districts, aiming to rescue an additional 4,500 girls. Urmila managed to escape after 13 years. She went back to school and with Plan backing has set up a photo studio in her village.
My parents had no way of knowing what would happen to me. This practice still exists, so we need to tell everyone so that other parents don't make the same mistake. My hope is to support this through my photography, taking photos of other children in the same situation.